Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with the new Hibernate tip. This time I will show you how to execute custom code before Hibernate persists an entity so that you can automatically initialize an entity attribute. The JPA specification defines a set of callback annotations to trigger method calls for certain lifecycle events. If you want to initialize an entity attribute before it gets persisted, you just have to do two things. You need to add a method to the entity which initializes the attribute, and you need to annotate this method with prepersist so that Hibernate calls it before it persists the entity. Let's get into the IDE and have a more detailed look at an example. Here you can see the author entity with a lifecycle callback that initializes the created at attribute. I annotated it with prepersist, and Hibernate will call this method when it persists a new author entity. Let's persist an author entity and check if we can find this log message. I prepared this simple test case for it. It creates and persists a new author entity. You can see the log messages here. This is the log message written by the initialize_created_at method. Hibernate calls it before it performs the SQA statements to get the primary key value and to persist the entity. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about Java 8 support in Hibernate, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below.